Happy Mercedesing. In this video, we're going to be talking about the
airflow sensor
again. And if you look at like this, it seems to be nothing wrong with it. But if you lay it down to be like this, as it should be, then we get this picture. Well, how do we repair our airflow meter? Let's watch it right now.
Let's say that you have stalled your engine and you get a picture like this, as you see here. This sensor plate has to be
way
up here, up to this mark. But it has fallen. It has fallen way downwards. What does this mean? This can mean both hard, cold, or warm starts. Well, what can we do to solve this issue? Our first thought would be this part here. This is the fuel accumulator. And I had an issue like that. Well, if you have also, if you haven't seen this video, you can look at this here, where I explain the difference between the fuel pressure regulator and the fuel accumulator, and how you can test this part if it is good operational or not. Now, the second thing, we can doubt this part, this 3 mm screw, the CO screw. But in order for the sensor plate to fall this much, you would have to turn this screw for at least 10 full turns counterclockwise. Well, what's the issue then? Your issue lies here underneath. And to get this part, as I got it, you will have to unscrew many, many things. You will have to unclip this EHA, and the main line from the fuel distributor, all these lines, the throttle lever, pretty much everything. You will have to do it. It's a real pain in the chest. And as you do, you will have to take this out of your car, and please, when taking it off from your car, let me just take off the fuel distributor. You don't have to take it off from this unit. I will, for the purpose of this video. Please, and I repeat, please, watch out for the hose clamp here that holds the throttle body. You will have to here to take off this breather hose that connects the idle control valve and the airflow sensor. And now we're going to unscrew. I have only these two. You will have to use this one. Something like this. Let it just be 10 mils. Let me now unscrew these two for you. We take this part off, the rubber boot, and watch it carefully. Observe. Look at this part here. this part mustn't be like this. It has to be like this. Here, pay attention to this part. This one. Look at it, how it rests. It has to hold this spring stretched like this. So that then your sensor plate can move a bit harder. In order to straighten this thing, you will need a torx key. This is a T30. And now, let's look at this. It's falling. Now, let's make it straight. Like this, as much as you can. And let's turn this screw in here, like this. Don't be afraid to screw it firmly. What do we get now? Does it fall now? So let me show you this. Now, What did we get? The issue solved. That's it. As simple as that. Afterwards, you just get it back in a reverse order. And there you have solved yourself an issue that here in Serbia costs 600 euros in a dealership if you want it repaired. And if you go to the dealership, 600 euros. This is how you can save your money. Well, it's going to last, but that's it. That's how you solve this problem. Here, look at the spring now. It's firm. Here, it doesn't fall. That would be pretty much everything for this video. And till some next one, happy Mercedesing. Bye.